Braun Strowman cashes in, KO quits. How's it going, my wrestling heroes? Some good highlights from this Raw. A lot of stuff stood out. This right here, Braun Strowman, after last Monday, he had to think of something, right? Obviously, if he plans on cashing this in, he's going to have to get strategic. The numbers game, it's against him. We got Dean Ambrose and Seth Rollins on Roman's ring corner. And he's like, you know what? We have an upcoming pay-per-view. We have Hell in a Cell, and what a great opportunity for me to outdo the numbers game. Obviously, if you're inside the structure, you know, there's no way that the numbers game is going to outdo him. So he said to Baron Corbin, I'm going to cash this. And I think this might be the first time in history where someone that has held the Money in the Bank briefcase, they kind of put the, you know, the briefcase on the line, you know, like 2-3 weeks ahead. He redeemed it tonight, but again, it's not going to take place until Hell in a Cell. They're going to be locked in the 20-foot structure. And he even gave it to Corbin. I think midway through Monday Night Raw, he put it in the middle over by, I think it was like at a table or something, making sure that he knew that this was it. There is no need for him to carry the Money in the Bank briefcase. It's going to happen. It's going to be the big dog versus Braun Strowman. Now, I'm pretty sure that something is still going to occur to where they'll either break the lock and Dean Ambrose and Seth Rollins will go in. I mean, it's going to happen. It's happened a lot in the past where they've climbed up to the top of the structure and fought up there. So again, you know, he's thinking that this is going to put him in a spot to where he doesn't have to worry about Rollins and Ambrose. Yeah, you got another thing coming, Braun Strowman. And then, so what ended up happening? Sorry, that was a little bit too much. But I just wanted to give you my thoughts as to what's going to go down when they finally go out. So Baron Corbin, I don't know what's going to happen with Kurt Angle. He is on vacation leave, but in one of his tweets, I think it was either on Instagram or Twitter, he said that he's going to be taking a vacation, not knowing if he was coming, if he's coming back. I'm sure he will. I think when he does come back, it'll most likely to take, you know, it'll be a match against Constable for him trying to take his spot. So anyways, long story short, he set up a match between Braun Strowman and Roman Reigns teaming up to take on Drew McIntyre and Dolph Ziggler. Now, this was the main event, so we'll get into that in just a sec. Again, this is mainly highlights. So this was what was established. Of course, they came out, and you know they're going to pick at what's at the leftovers. And I kind of actually see that playing out at Hell in a Cell. So this was the main event, and again, we'll get a little bit later on. Constable Corbin, he wanted to call out, and I want to do the following to this because I don't know why this is still going on. It still doesn't make sense why him and Finn Balor are still going at it. They had one more match, but for what, dude? I mean, what was the point of this? I feel like the whole thing at the previous pay-per-view, him coming out as Demon Balor, and just, it was a squash match is what it was. I don't know what the whole point of this was. Of course, Finn Balor, he was about to capture a clean win, and he had that trusty steel chair, man. He's like, nah, that ain't happening. He grabbed the chair and just started beating him over the head. Well, not over the head, but he started utilizing this chair. Again, this feud, why isn't this over yet? Seriously. But again, this is what basically led up to this match. And then we had the B team. It was a clean loss. The Revival, again, they came out and they said they're kind of a disgrace to the tag team division. In a way, I can kind of agree with what they're going with this. It doesn't make much sense as to what the how these guys, again, these were more of a comedy show more than any. Before they put the tag team titles on the B team, they were more of a comedy act. So the fact that they've held the titles and they've beaten some good teams like Clean. I mean, well, luck. I guess you could say more luck. So the Revival, I think what's going to happen, this is going to be a buildup, you know, for a feud for Hell in a Cell. So again, we'll get into a little bit more. I definitely want to get into that pay-per-view. Let's get into the next highlight. I'm starting to come around the fact that Seth Rollins is just... look, AJ, he's the GOAT, at least for current roster. But Rollins, bro, I think they're neck and neck. He's had so many matches this year alone. I mean, throughout the years in general, he's had so many matches that have stood out. But this one is going in the books as one of the greatest matches. They had the crowd, man. I mean, they were chanting and cheering. This was just a close bout overall. But again, at the end of the night, Rollins, he retained, and it was for the IC title. They went into commercial break. Kevin Owens, he was sitting in the middle of the ring, not doing anything. He was just sitting there, quiet. The crowd was wondering what was going to happen, what was going to go down next. And he just grabbed the mic, and plain and simple, he said, I quit. He said that he's done. Well, he just said he quits. But What does this mean? I mean, does this mean that he quits as in, like, he quits Raw? Or does he quit and now he's going over to SmackDown? Or is he just kind of saying this so he can get another title opportunity? And I can see his frustration. I mean, if you really think about his recent run in the last 2-3 months, he's been getting squashed by Braun Strowman. And now, I mean, this match, it really helped him out. I think it really helped him out to still kind of prove that he's one of the best guys in Raw. But what is, again, a lot of questions. I don't think he quit. If he did, man, I hope you come back soon, because, again, this is one of my favorite guys on Raw. But, yes, KO quit on us, unfortunately. Who wants to walk with Elias? Unfortunately, not the ladies. He got kicked out of the ring. He was about to have his concert. He was. But you know what? It was just something to get the promo going for the upcoming women's pay-per-view. Trish Stratus. Yes, I did say Trish Stratus. Trending worldwide, by the way, so good for you. She still has, you know, all of her fans behind her. She came out and she kind of started to promote the upcoming pay-per-view for the all-women's. I guess she's going to be taking on Alexa Bliss. So this is cool. And look, it was originally a singles match. It was Natalya against Alicia Fox. But you know what would have been awesome? I think it just might happen next week. I think it's just a little tease to get everything going. But I would have loved to see like a 3-on-3. This would have been epic. I mean, you guys aren't familiar with Trish Stratus and Mickie James. They got history together. So seeing that rivalry being revived, it would have been awesome. Plus Ronda in the mix. But this match right here, they were in Canada. So, you know, the fan favorite. Well, either way, the face is going to win this, whether it was in Canada or U.S. But again, easy win for Natalya. Apparently, the Ascension still have a job. So what had happened? We didn't know who was going to take on Bobby Lashley. Constable back at it again. I feel like Constable had a lot to do with a lot of what went down tonight. These two, they came out, like I said, it was a 1-on-2 match, and it was just a simple squash. Bobby Lashley, yeah, he pinned both of them clean. And now, what are they trying to do? My question, like, are they trying to build him up again to where they're going to put him into the top card division? It didn't make sense. Like, they did it, they threw him right back down, and now it looks like they're trying to build him back up. But yeah, clean win by Bobby Lashley. Ambrose has not only changed his look, but his overall style, his in-ring ability has always been great, but ever since his return, he's just a whole new character. He is going out there, he's focused. He had a match against Jinder Mahal. Mahal was going for the Colossus, but Dean Ambrose countered it. Dirty deeds, and this was in the last that we saw of Ambrose. He did eventually end up coming out a little bit later on, but I'll get to that in just a sec. But yes, Dean Ambrose for the win. This was set up for failure from the get-go. Constable, he's like, you know what? We put this man through a table last Monday. How about we do this? How about we put him together and go up against two of the top? I mean, they're not like an actual, well, they are a team. They are a tag team, but they're not like in a tag team division. But two of the best, you know, together on Raw right now. And this, I knew it's been in the works. I knew that Braun Strowman turning heel, I know that's kind of what they've been trying to work for. Because obviously it wouldn't make sense, you know, to have a face against a face at Hell in a Cell for the Universal title. So this was kind of payback. It's what it was. I mean, the entire match, Roman Reigns, he was getting beat up. And he had Braun Strowman in the corner trying to reach for a tag, right? Eventually he got tagged, but it was just for a simple beatdown, right? Braun Strowman, yeah, he had his way, not just with Roman Reigns, but Dean Ambrose also came out. Oh yeah, they all got the taste of the power slam. And you know what? If I was Braun Strowman, oh yeah, I would go ahead and do the same. What they did to him last Monday, and don't get me, I love the Shield. The Shield are like my three of my favorite guys on Raw. But, I mean, it was payback. And he was actually standing, when it was all said and done at the end of the night, he was actually standing in the middle of the ring with these two, just confirming to the WWE Universe that this is an official heel turn by Braun Strowman. I do like where this is heading. I actually think that this build-up right here, what they're doing for towards Hell in a Cell, this is great. Really enjoying this. So really hyped to see what more is to come from Braun Strowman. Drop it in the comment section. Would love to hear your favorite part of the night. I got to rank Raw a solid, just a great Raw. I mean, this one, from beginning to end, it was just a lot of great just feuds, matches. I got to give it a solid 9. I think Raw was great. The finish, yeah, this is kind of what made up for him getting put through the table last Monday Monday Night Raw. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Be sure to hit the subscribe button if you're new to the channel, and we'll see you on the next one.